The time is now 18 minutes past seven. Up until a few days ago, businesses across the country had been preparing for the UK to leave the EU tonight. Darshini's here now to discuss how they've had to change gear. Darshini?
Thanks, Michelle. Yes, not only, of course, are they having to steer towards a fourth Brexit deadline, they're also having to navigate that December election. Brompton, which is known for its folding bikes and increasingly for its e-bikes too, exports the majority of its bikes. It's stockpiled £1.3 million worth of parts to prepare for the eventuality of a no-deal Brexit. Well, Will Butler-Adams, the Managing Director of Brompton, is with us this morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
You are a British brand, but your customers, your suppliers are all over the world. So what kind of toll is all this uncertainty taking? Because you don't even know what the future trading relationship could look like.
Well, there hasn't been too much uncertainty if you assume you just 3 years ago take the worst case scenario and plan for that. And that's all we've done. We looked at what would have been the hardest impact on our business, which was a no Brexit, decided what we'd do to mitigate that. And then we got back to worrying about our business, innovating, coming up with funky products, exporting. The interesting thing now is that we've got an election and that changes the landscape a bit. Our business is about trying to make people a bit happier, trying to change how people live in cities. And if we can contribute anything in the next, you know, coming months, it is to put pressure on all parties to think about how we invest in our infrastructure, to change the nature of our cities from cities designed around square metal boxes called cars to designing them around people, to make better infrastructure. We're investing a tiddly amount in active travel. I don't know what it's about.
So basically make it easier for people to bike around.
But bike, but not, you know, be stuffed under the ground in the dark or spend 80 billion on a train that, quite frankly, you know, we don't need. We need to make our cities better. And that's what we've been doing. And I suppose in the next couple of months, that's the bit that we can get excited about and not worry about Brexit, because we've dealt with that 3 years ago.
Yeah, but you are held up quite often as a British success story. We saw the International Trade Secretary, for example, posing for photos under the Sydney Bridge on one of your bikes. We just heard the Transport Secretary there.
Yeah.
He's not talking about infrastructure. He's not talking about the needs of business or indeed the population. He's talking about Brexit. He's talking about events in Westminster. Yep. We're going to hear from Shadow Cabinet Ministers later. Are politicians getting this? Do they understand what business needs?
I think they are going to be massively distracted by Brexit. Of course they are. But therefore, in business, we understand our world. We are, you know, that's all we care about in our context, is trying to make cities a little bit better. And therefore, we've got to do our bit and influence policy. Of course, they're going to be focused on Brexit, but that's not what we're focused on. If all we'd done in business is focus on Brexit, we wouldn't have moved a step forward. And we haven't done that. We've focused on our customer. We understand what's going on in the rest of the world. We've got to bring that insight to the UK to make the UK a nicer place to live. We've got health problems. We've got massive investments in the NHS because people are getting up in the morning, sitting on a tube, sitting at a desk, sitting on a tube, and going to bed. And that doesn't make us happy. We've got to get on our legs, we've got to get on our bikes and whiz about.
So plenty there for the politicians to consider as they put together their manifestos. We wait and see whether they're listening or not. Well, Butler-Adams, good to talk to you. Thank you.
Thank you very much.